99% of the time, when an iPad has a battery problem, it's because of the software, not the hardware, not the battery itself. So we're gonna show you how to fix a bunch of software problems that can cause battery drain, starting in the settings app.
Yeah, so let's go to the mail settings on your iPad.
All right, scrolling down, tap in mail.
Tap accounts.
Tap accounts.
And then tap fetch new data.
Fetch new data.
This switch at the top of the screen, we wanna turn that right off.
Boom. So with push on, new data will be pushed to your iPad from the server when possible. So your iPad maintains a connection to the server, says, is there mail? Is there mail? Is there mail? Is there mail? By turning this off, you get to choose how often your iPad checks to see if there's new mail. Then under fetch, we're gonna choose every 15 minutes or every 30 minutes or hourly.
Whatever works for you. You can also open the mail app at any time to get your mail.
Boom, instantly it downloads. Yeah. So you're not gonna notice a difference unless you really need that mail up to the second.
For better battery life, fetch less frequently. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked that tip. Yep. Let's go to privacy.
Boom.
Tap on location services.
All right, location services.
And look for any apps that say always.
All right, let's look through the list. Always is dangerous because it means the app can use your location all the time, which can drain your battery. Google Home, I don't even use that. I'm gonna change it all the way back to never.
And this is a big killer too. Can we just tap on that real quick?
Nope.
Nope.
We're gonna find another one that has always and then do it.
Big killer here, precise location plus always.
Right, this is a good example because the MLB app needs to know where I am so that it can not show me games that I'm interested in by blacking them out because I'm interested in them and I pay the subscription. So why should I be able to watch the Yankee game? That would make sense. Okay, then tap while using the app because it doesn't need to know where I am all the time. So not precisely, that uses more battery. You get the idea. Tap back to location services.
Tap on system services.
All right.
We've got a whole bunch of switches on, a whole bunch of scary purple arrows here. We're gonna turn most of these switches off. We're gonna leave on emergency calls and SOS and find my iPad.
All right, HomeKit, location-based alerts, networking.
Oh.
Turning off networking and wireless may affect Bluetooth and Wi-Fi performance.
Wi-Fi
performance. If you go to a different country, this is true. If you stay in the United States, it's not true. Just tap turn off. It's because it uses your location in areas where Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are configured differently. It's not configured differently in California than it is in Wisconsin. Newsflash.
Yeah, setting time zone again. Yeah. If you travel to a different time zone, turn it on. Time zone updates, turn it off. You don't need to have that always on.
Right, David actually tried this recently.
He went to Greece
test this setting.
It was off and then I turned it on and then boom, it updated and then I turned it off again. And
right, this is what we do.
Haven't lost track of time. Let's tap on significant locations next.
All right, Touch ID.
Used to be frequent locations, Apple said. That's weird.
That's freaky.
Let's just turn this switch off. It's constantly saving information about the places you visit most often with your iPad.
It's less of a privacy issue than it is a battery issue.
Right.
Just does not need to be happening all the time. The reason you don't see anything from here is that I don't ever leave the house. Actually, it's because I leave this off all the time, but because we're awesome and you should subscribe, we went through and I go in and I turn on all these settings before we even start making the video.
Tedious.
It's a process that you could hit subscribe to say thank you for.
iPad analytics, routing and traffic, turn those off. Apple can improve their own products.
Right.
But we are gonna turn on the status bar icon. Why are we doing that?
Because by turning on the status bar icon, you get this little arrow in the upper right-hand corner of your iPad next to the Wi-Fi. And then you can tell when your iPad is tracking your location, and if that little arrow is on all the time, it could indicate a battery problem. You can see that even Find My iPad is using my location right now. That's the purple arrow. Gray, last 24 hours. Hollow purple arrow, geofencing. Big battery drainer.
Tap back to location services. Tap back to privacy.
Boom.
We're gonna scroll down. I guess we're not to scroll at all. Analytics and improvements.
We're used to iPhones.
Yeah.
These are bigger screens.
Turn these off.
Well, should I go one at a time or should
I just? Well, you can just do the top switch. Boom.
Boom.
All at once. This will use battery life. Can use a little bit of cellular data on iPhones too.
Right.
So just be careful. Apple can improve their own products.
Their own gosh darn products. All right, tap back to privacy or did I jump ahead there? We did everything we possibly could in that section of the
That was everything in privacy. We did it.
Wow.
It's a lot of stuff. There's still more tips, but as I said earlier, subscribe to this channel.
Right.
Give this video a thumbs up. We've given you a lot of really good tips so far.
Come on.
Just saying.
Yeah.
So let's talk about something kind of controversial in Apple spaces. That's closing out of apps.
But you should never have to close out of your apps, David.
You should never have to, but apps are not perfect.
Yep.
Screws fall out all the time.
Unlike us. But close out your apps on an iPad without a home button. Swipe your finger from the very bottom of the screen, then let go, and you get a list of all your apps. Swipe them off the top of the screen.
Yep.
Boom. How do you do it if you have an iPad with a home button?
Well, press the home button, app switcher, swipe up.
Swipe up.
Nice yep. and easy.
See you later.
Let's go to another classic tip. Background app refresh. Tap general.
All right. Scrolling up to general on the left. Boom.
Tap background app refresh.
Okay.
Got a lot of switches on here that don't need to be on. When this is on for an app, that app can download new content in the background of your iPad all the time. Battery drainer.
Yeah, you're not using the app. You don't need it on. Even Apple admits now that it is a battery drainer.
I'm turning off apps may help preserve battery life. We told you.
Yep. Every single time you hit one of these switches,
save a little bit of battery life.
A little bit more battery life.
Messaging apps, for example, like Slack or Snapchat or Facebook Messenger, you probably want to leave it on so those messages do load and load.
Yep, they're loud.
Load. In the background of your iPad.
Right. But other stuff like Star Trek.
Star Trek, is that a game?
It is a game. Hmm. It's part of Apple Arcade. I've never opened it, unlike every other thing in Apple Arcade. Ugh.
So let's go to accessibility next.
So under general, accessibility.
Yeah, let's tap on display and text size.
Okay.
And we'll talk about reduce white point.
All right. So if we turn it on, you'll notice that my screen gets slightly darker, which is a way to save battery life. I like to back it off to 50%-ish. You can still use the slider to adjust the brightness. We have it sort of set at this level right now, just so it looks really good to you.
Overhead
welcome,
cam.
Overhead cam. Yeah. So we turn it off for the video, but it kind of recalibrates the brightness slider so that the bright isn't quite as bright, but it's still really bright. Saves battery.
Set back to accessibility.
Okay.
Then tap on motion.
All right.
Reduce motion. This will cut down on some of the animations you see on your iPad.
Right. Animations use battery life. This is a little battery tip. Some of them are huge, like push, location services. Some of them are little, but they all add up. Now, if I swipe up from the bottom of the screen, you'll notice it does a cool little fade. Some people prefer the cross dissolve to the swipey and all the motion going around.
Yep. Well, we actually want to go back to the home screen, so let's show them again. Let's talk about removing unnecessary widgets. These are little mini apps, and now with iPadOS 15, you can add this to your home screen on your iPad, and they can just use a lot of battery life if you've got a whole bunch of them.
Right. So what I'll do is I'll swipe from right to left on my home screen to bring up my main little list of widgets here. So how do we remove them?
Well, you can press and hold on a widget.
Okay. Does it matter which one?
Well, it's faster if you press and hold the one you want to remove.
Okay.
Then tap remove widget. Tap remove. You can also press and hold on any widget and then tap edit home screen and then just tap these minus buttons next to the widget if you want to delete a whole bunch at once.
All right, so let's do this one. Get rid of that.
Remove.
What about these? What about these widgets down here?
Oh.
They're legacy widgets. They're the old ones. I have to tap edit at the bottom here and then
Customize.
You got to tap on it.
There we go.
I just missed it.
And then you can just tap these little red minus buttons, tap remove. Or you can also swipe. Nope, you can't. Okay, remove. Throw me through a loop here.
Yep, through the loop. For a loop, through a loop, whatever.
Right? What I say?
You said, throw me through a loop.
Oh, I always say that, but it's for a loop.
Yep.
I looked it up the other day.
Yeah.
Let's go back to the settings app.
All right, tap in there. Tap it on settings to open it back up.
Display and brightness.
Boom.
This tip, save a little bit of battery life. Turn on that dark mode.
Boom.
Looks cool.
Looks cooler.
We finally have it.
Yeah, we've been asking for it for a long time. Auto lock. I have it set on never right now. 2 minutes, 5 minutes. Why is it on never? Because
we're doing a screen recording.
We're doing a screen recording.
If auto lock is set to never and you don't remember to lock your iPad, the display is just on. I've actually had that issue here where we turn it on to never.
Yeah.
For our screen recordings, I forget to switch it back and then my battery dies and I don't know why. And I'm like, oh.
Right. The only thing that would make me feel better is if we had another subscriber.
Hit that subscribe button. Update your iPad when iPadOS updates become available. They can fix software bugs, introduce cool new features. Always good to keep your iPad up to date.
Yep. So let's tap general, then tap software update at the top. Wait as it checks, then you can just tap install later. Right now, mine is in the process of automatically downloading the iPad developer beta.
Also, restart your iPad once a week. Give it a little bit of a fresh start every now and then.
So to restart your iPad, a lot of people don't realize that the process has changed. So on this iPad, for instance, without a home button, it's the top button and either volume button. Press and hold them together. Then you can see the slide to power off thing, slide to power off. If you hold just the top button now, you get Siri. And she won't turn it off for you. She's like,
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Doesn't tell you how.
All their iPads with the home button is just press and hold that power button. If you like these tips, consider joining our channel like these fine folks.
All right, let's start with Mike here. Mike is an awesome guy, and he has a YouTube channel that is also pretty awesome. He also won a 4-pack of AirTags by being a channel member. So Mike, check him out. I can see this through the back of the page. Daniel Woodard. We don't know much about him. He's just a D. But Walt Hanks, fine-looking gentleman at the top. Thank you, Walt.
Yeah, these people, as well as all of our YouTube members, got early access to our iOS 15 battery tips video, kind of the counterpart to this video.
Right.
We also get
the
Discord,
sister video.
Discord, yep. Access.
Yep.
A lot of great perks.
And we give away stuff in the Discord.
Yep.
It's awesome. You get to talk to us.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Yeah, hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.